Good day everyone, and welcome to another episode of Idiotic Indian Reviewer. Today I'm extremely happy because my last video had 7,000 views. I thank everyone who watched the video. I thank everyone who had subscribed, liked and commented on my video. And on this note, let us begin another topic. So recently, I have been checking the social media. A name has been arising so fast, so tremendous, and it is called the ABCD of Kerala Blasters. Yeah, you heard it right. It's ABC. Like you have BBC in Real Madrid, that is Benzema, Bale and Cristiano Ronaldo. So it is similar to that. You have MSN, that is your Messi, Suarez and Neymar, and you have RIP in Manchester United, which is Rooney, Ibrahimovic and Pogba. So similar to that, we fans have created something unique called ABCD, that is the Antonio German, Belfort, Michael Chopra and Dukins. So it's going to be so deadly. We have unlikely not the trio, we have four. So let's talk about them, talk about the ABCD and their achievements and their plus points. So let us begin our episode. The funniest part is that these ABCD cannot play simultaneously on field due to the field player restriction the ISL has. ISL have certain rules that it says that there should be certain amount of foreign player mixed with the larger amount of Indian players. So it is extremely difficult to the coach or for the coach to set all these four players into action. So I think ABCD is not practical. It's my view. I think ABCD is not a reliable plan to stick on. But let's talk, what if the ABCD comes into action? So about Antonio German, you all are familiar with Antonio German. He is extremely good player. He had an injury last season, but he played his best. But he needs someone who would support him to score. So I think Michael Chopra can give some awesome passes. Michael Chopra is great player. Last season he had some constraints with his ankle, so I think Michael Chopra can assist Antonio German to some extent, or to have a partner. You need a partner to score a goal. You cannot be a one-man army in a football is a game of team. So I think Chopra with Antonio German will be a deadly combo. So that would bring to AC, that is AC from ABCD. And we don't know much about the other two players, that is Belfort and Dukins. I'm sorry, the audio got glitched. And let's talk about Belfort. He's an Haitian footballer who played for Trabzon. I don't know, how do you pronounce that? It's Trabzon, a club called Trabzon. He is 24 years of age and he's an extremely good striker. He strikes the ball like an arrow, and I don't think any of our goalkeeper except Apollo Eder can stop. I think Apollo Eder is a brilliant goalkeeper that we have in ISL. And it would be better if we bring Gurpreet Singh Sadhu I don't know how do you pronounce the Gurpreet Singh Sadhu to Indian Super League, but it would eventually, you know, degrade his growth, because he has been growing tremendously because he is abroad. I'm not criticizing Indian Super League, I'm just saying the truth. You have seen the last match between India and Puerto Rico. There are some exceptional players who stood out in the tournament, and one of them was obviously our goalkeeper Gurpreet, and he was off the mark. He was just more than brilliant in saving the goals. And other player who did well in India and Puerto Rico was JJ. I think JJ had a lot of misunderstanding with the players, but Sunil Chhetri was an elder leader, and Jingen, as usual, did his 100%. So let's not deviate from the topic, let's get back to the ABCD. So I was telling that Michael Chopra could help Antonio German to score, whereas Belfort is a keen striker, and I think Belfort with the combination of Duckins would be another option for Kerala Blasters, so they can use the duo alternative, that is ABCD, shuffling them aside, checking out which combo works deadly. As you have seen last season, Mendoza and Elano was the deadliest combo ever in ISL. They had so much understanding, they scored internationally best scored goals, and they found the weakness of the defender, they charged to the defender, they penetrated the defense like, you know, a smooth slice of knife in a cake. It was so beautifully executed. So we need to shuffle this ABCD and find out which two of them is the deadliest combo, and which two of them would penetrate the defense of other teams. So let's wait and see what happens in future. Yeah, I hope we'll find in pre-season, we'll get to know the deadliest combo in pre-season and execute in the upcoming match with Northeast United on 1st October. And another news that we got is that today we unveiled the Kerala Blasters jersey, and I personally am disappointed, because you know, it is not the way. You can take this as a constructive comment or constructive criticism, because this is not the way you unveil the jersey. The jersey should be unveiled. Have you seen Manchester United unveiling the jersey? It must be done by the manufacturer, the kit manufacturer. And every time Kerala Blasters unveil a jersey, it's like a, you know, it's like a beating around bush. Yeah, they show, okay, it's an yellow jersey with a blue stripe on neck. It was in first season, I think. Then they showed, okay, it's yellow jersey, just yellow with Muthoot. See, title sponsor comes second. You need to have manufacturer first, because it gives you the idea of the quality of the product. So I think this was the worst unveiling of jersey that had happened. So I would suggest from next season, you must have an away jersey which is much different than that of our main course. I could call it main course jersey. And yes, as we are tied to the logo, that yellow make halo, so you can have yellow, but different combinations of, we can prioritize the color. Can we could make blue the away jersey a blue with a combination of yellow less, so that could bring a different jersey. I'm not happy with the away jersey, and I'm not happy with the unveiling of the jersey that had taken place today. And there was a important thing that had happened is that there is a new youth ambassador for the team, that is the Nivin Pauly. Yeah, the Premam actor himself is the youth ambassador for Kerala Blasters. And that's it for now. And I think, sorry. There's one more thing to tell you, that India is going to Thailand for pre-season. That is what I have heard. And let's pray for a Kerala Blasters. I think the coach had told the media that the reason for going to Thailand is that it matches the weather condition with India, because we have to play in tropical region, as the weather matches with Thailand. If you go to Europe, it's coldest, and when we come back, there will be a diverse effect in health. So I think it's a good move. It's good move that we are going to Kerala. At least we are not playing with the local clubs of India. We may play with some comparatively stronger teams. So let's see what happens. Let's see how the team builds up, how the team plays. And till then we will keep criticizing. We will just get to the point to make the good team, and hope our Kerala Blaster brings the trophy to the street. And that's it. That's all we fans want. We need the trophy desperately. And once again, I thank all my subscribers, all my well-wishers, and please support me. Please give me some constructive idea. I know I don't have a good mic. No, as I eventually become bigger, I'll get a new mic and podcast you like this. And thanks for being with me. Thanks for listening. Please share, comment, please subscribe and share this video, and let's hit 1k, please. I know I'm over ambitious. Just let's pray for the good and let's get 1k subscribers. Thank you. And Indiotic Indian Reviewer is signing off. Bye bye.